Songhezo Gym, Cape Town, South Africa. That passion and desire of being a professional cyclist, it actually developed from Cape Town, where I actually got to see the Cape Agulhas Peak and Base Cycle Tour. That's where I actually got interest into the cycling industry. I was just watching the race. By then, it was 2005, by then I didn't even know how to ride a bicycle. And then just one of my friends actually just introduced, because the race went past my house. And then he just introduced me into cycling, and then I actually got to get involved by that way. My first time I took part was in 2006, because I only started cycling in 2005. And I've been doing that race each and every year, and it's growing each and every year. They are so, and everything about that race is just great. To be not able to ride a bike and now to be able to win a professional cycling team, it was actually not an easy step to take. He actually had to taught me how to ride in his BMX first, and then from there I had to step up to ride a mountain bike, and then from there it's a long process. You have to just take time, and you also just have to be dedicated and work hard. That's the only way to be able to do it. Since I've been a professional, the highlight for me has been when I was actually selected to go represent my country in so many occasions. That was actually one of my highlights, and also I just recently came third in the Under 23s in African Champs in Burkina Faso, so that's actually one of my highlights in my cycling career. My dream is to be able to go and ride the Tour de France one day, to win a Pro Tour team with Team MTN Quebec powered by Samsung. I want to see myself in a few years' time being a better person and a better rider, being able to do whatever that I can be able to do for the team. To be part of this bike team, it means a lot to me. Actually, the Quebec program, it is an organization that actually gives kids bicycles, but it doesn't just give them bicycles. It actually, you have to grow trees in order to earn the bike. So they don't just actually give them bicycles, so they actually have to grow trees, 100 trees, then they'll get one bike in return. So that actually means a lot, because it actually changes so many people's life in Africa. And also, like, there are about so many people who are walking to school. So those Quebec bicycles, they actually help them a lot in order to save some more time, to be able to study, to be able to do some other things. Like, also, if you're walking to school in the morning and you come back late, you won't even be able to take part in the sports, you won't be able to do sports, you won't be able to study well because you get back home and it's dark and everything. So with those Quebec bicycles, they actually have to, they get back home earlier, they can be able to go take, do some other stuff like do sports, cycling, soccer. They will have time to go practice and also have time, more time to study as well. So that's actually a good job that's actually the Quebec organization is doing.
Songhezo Gym is a is an incredible bike rider from an incredible past, and a guy that that I think has won the hearts of many of the media that that has come to our training camp, and is also, you know, a guy that is going to be loved by most people around the world. He's got a great smile, and he suffers like crazy, and I see Songhezo being an integral part of the team and our team's performances in any event that he rides this year. He's not a race winner yet, but I think as he builds strength and gets more mileage in his legs, he will be a force to be reckoned with in the next 2 years.